Hey everybody, it's Adrian Ortiz, AMO Fitness, and today we're going to talk about the deck squat. So, the deck squat is a rolling squat. So what you do, hopefully I can do this one of these guys out of the way. Ruby puppies! Okay, as I roll back, get into my squat, and I stand on up. Okay, so to be able to do that requires a lot of joint mobility, first and foremost, neuromuscular control of your lumbopelvic hip complex. And in general, it's a little bit of a skill, so you have to practice at it for it to become a technical skill set. So things that you're gonna need is a really good warm-up. So we wanna start with the beginning movement, which is just rocking in and out of a core position. So I'm gonna just rock back, and then I'm gonna rock forward till I tap my knees on the ground, and then I'm gonna rock back. Okay, you can push off gently. Okay, you can keep a good tight upper back if you want, but in this drill, your butt is going to be coming from a tail tucked position. I know it's not something that we coach, but it's something you might want to play with. Untucked and tucked, untucked and tucked, just so you know the difference. Okay, so rocking back and forth, okay? Next is being able to transfer my weight from back to forward. So as you come out of the roll here, as I'm coming forward, I need to be able to know how to transfer out of that. So good drills to get into the most comfortable deep goblet squat you can and just transfer back. So you can start seated, rock forward, okay? Push, you can even end up swooping that hand forward, just rocking back and forth, okay? And then third is to just practice the rocking component of it. So I'm gonna get tight here, okay? I'm gonna hit every vertebra on the way back, so I don't wanna end up doing this and smacking my core on the ground. I want to be able to keep it tight, so I should hit every vertebrae, especially in the lumbar, so I have to keep my pelvis tucked very tight as I roll, hitting every vertebrae on the ground. I wouldn't recommend doing this on hardwood like I'm doing right now, because it's not very fun, but we're going back and forth, about 10 sets. Now, if you're still having trouble, use something like a couch or a chair to assist you getting up. Okay, so let's say you're doing pretty good getting the rocking, but you just can't get up, grab the couch and assist you up, okay? So you can just use anything to help grab and assist. I have a little foam roller here, okay? I'm gonna rock back, okay? I'm gonna come forward, I'm gonna grab and assist, okay? And it could be anything. So breaking down that movement, and you can choose any one of those where you tend to fall at. If you're lacking a lot of ankle mobility, that would be the first thing to address. And hip mobility, which the goblet squat is great for opening up the hips and stacking the spine correctly. Okay, so those are three things I would work on. Now, why do we use the deck squat? I use the deck squat as a full body propulsion movement, and it's an auxiliary exercise to a squat. I still would rather squat, goblet squat, jump squat, level change, sprawl, stuff like that. That doesn't say that this does not have benefits. This is such a beneficial exercise that the Europeans use as a test of mortality. If people can pass or not pass, how long their lifespan is going to be. So if it's that important, it might be something that we should try to check out or play with within our exercise program. If you are severely deconditioned or have injuries in any of the kinetic chain joints, I wouldn't recommend doing the full version, but that's not to say you can't just start playing around with some rocking motions, okay? Doing some, maybe some assisted squats up and down. That would be the first thing, is to teach you how to squat correctly and through proper range of motion. That would be the first thing to attack, and always pay attention to really good alignment of the ankle and the knee. Make sure as a coach, when you're watching this, watch what their feet do. I have a lot of people that end up doing this to come up. That might be an indicator of something if they're passing their screen in other areas. So it's a movement screen as well. So have fun with that. That's the deck squat. It's a little tutorial. If you're gonna use it in a program, it can be used as a warm-up. It can be used in between drills, as maybe a mobility exercise. It can be used for level changes for coaches that need to teach their kids to get up quickly. That's obviously a skill set we wanna practice. And I like to use it as a small bit of a conditioning drill with other drills. So one of my favorite ways to use a deck squat is to pair it with sprawls, sit-throughs, and deck squats. Probably one of my three favorite in-home kind of little mobility and conditioning circuit. All three of those are great exercises and not terribly impactful. Even the sprawl, you can kind of really break down that it's not impactful. All right, so it's a deck squat tutorial, AMO Fitness. And this little guy says, hey, what's up, guys? See ya.